Pour in the chicken curry with this nice gravy. Wow. Today, I'm going to make chicken recipe. This is going to have a lot of gravy. Gravy comes with onions, with coconut, with tomatoes. We're going to add the chicken pieces. Gravy will be so tasty that you will enjoy it with the rice. We take the leftover rice, put in a blender. With that, I'm going to make a roti. You know, everybody loves. And first, you know, I'm going to try it with this and dip in this curry. Namaste, Salaam Alaikum, Sasriyakal. Welcome back to another session with your Vahchef at Vareva.com. Today, I'm going to make another chicken recipe. This is a very interesting recipe because this is going to have a lot of gravy. You know, a lot of people have been asking me, oh, can you show a mutton, Telangana mutton curry, where there is going to be a lot of gravy. So the gravy comes with onions, with coconut, with tomatoes. So today we're going to use the chironji. Chironji and coconut. And there'll be a lot of gravy, and the gravy, because of the coconut, this is loved by South Indians. And this chironji is the kind of Mughalai kind of thing. Instead of using, you know, peanuts or cashew nut, we use chironji. And if you don't have chironji, you can use the regular nuts. First, we need to make a paste of dry coconut. And then we're going to add the chironji. First, make the dry coconut powder and then add chironji. Add water, make this into a nice paste. After which, I'm going to show you how to make this recipe. We're going to add oil. Because this is going to be a lot of gravy, once the oil is getting heated, we're going to add the whole garam masala, cardamom, clove, in this bay leaf and some cinnamon. Add some cumin, add onion. We're going to have this onion slightly colored and add some salt. When I say I'm going to let these onions colored, they're going to get slightly brown. But if you make it too much brown, again, it will become like a very fine gravy. You want the gravy that will be thickening. So you want the onions to sweat, still hold the gravy. So let these onions cook till they get slight coloring. When the onions are slightly colored, we're going to add some ginger garlic paste. Ginger garlic paste also will make a nice gravy. In this, we're going to add the paste of coconut and chironji. And this one, just like cashew, this will start sticking at the bottom. You need to be a little bit careful. And also in this, we're going to add the turmeric. The coconut has a tendency to make, you know, a lot of gravy, but it has to be cooked well. Otherwise, you will have that raw kind of flavor, which is not good. Once you mix all of this, in this, we're going to add the tomatoes. These tomatoes also will give kind of sourness to the gravy, which a lot of people will love. Add tomatoes, mix into this. Once it stops sticking at the bottom and you can see some of the oil coming out, in this we're going to add the chicken pieces. I'm going to let it cook for another 3-4 minutes like this before I add water. The number one masala will give the substance to the curry is chili powder. Add this much chili powder is good enough. Coriander powder also is another gravy giving thing, and some cumin seed powder. But at the same time, be careful, at the bottom it should not stick. Keep stirring it like this for another 2-3 minutes. You will see these tomatoes will get, you know, almost disappearing. In this, we're going to add water. And this is going to be a lot of gravy. By the time the chicken is ready, the gravy also will be ready. In this, I'm going to add some green chili, also some mint leaf. And this will give a very nice flavor. You know, a lot of people, they love it, especially when they are eating with this with naan, roti, or even simple pulao. This mint will add a lot of flavor. Gravy will be so tasty that you will enjoy it with the rice. It will become a very nice gravy. When you're making the mutton, the color will be slightly darker in color. And this one is perfect. We're going to put the lid on and let it simmer in its own juices. That's when you'll get the, you know, perfect taste. So I'm going to show you another, you know, bread. This is again with leftover rice. So what we do is, we take the leftover rice and put it in the fridge. Then this will become like grains, you know. This is like a little bit hard. Then put in a blender and make it like a paste, or it will become slightly grainy kind of powder. So with that, I'm going to make a roti, and that too curry leaf roti, and this is going to be very tasty. I put this already in the blender. After you put in the blender, because this is a cold rice, this has become grainy like this. In this, we're going to add chapati atta. For 2 cups of rice, add 1 cup of chapati atta. And in this, We're going to add some salt. Since we are making this curry leaf rice, we're going to use a lot of curry leaves, finely chopped. That will give a very nice green color and also a lot of flavor for the roti, what we're going to do. In this, we're going to add cumin seeds, add some chopped green chili, and in this, add some crushed coriander seeds, and in this, add some chopped garlic. Curry leaf and garlic, nice combination. But first, we're going to make this into a dough. Here, add water, knead this just how you make your chapati dough. And nice, this green color and all this will make it excellent. This mixture is all ready. So just knead it a little bit and then we're going to convert this into nice rotis. We got very nice and lot of gravy. In this, just finish it off by adding some chopped coriander. But here, atta, whatever we have done, we're going to roll this into nice roti. You have to add little bit of extra flour, you know, all-purpose flour, and then we're going to roll it into thin. So then it'll come out nice, and when the roti is done, this will look so good that you will be so happy. Add little extra flour on top, just rub it and then roll it thin. When the roti is all done, put it on a plate. I'm going to move the chicken curry because this is all done, and we're going to cook this. You know, if you want to add ghee, butter, anything. But when this is cooking, you will get this nice curry leaf fragrance which you will fall in love with. Whenever you're making the rotis, put it on a hot tawa. They come out nice and perfect. Just give it a rotation like this. It will get evenly colored and it will also be good. Cook a little bit on one side, then transfer it to the other side. Actually, there is a very light coloring. When you add butter, you need to be careful because the tawa is very hot and the butter will discolor. That's not going to happen with the oil or ghee. Add a little bit, give it a nice coating of ghee. Turn it to the other side. Look at that heat. Because of the ghee, it will get nicely colored and now I can get the fantastic aroma. Now this side also, some ghee. I don't want the other side to be burnt. So careful and look at this. You want this to be nicely cooked and the fragrance is just outstanding. With this chicken curry or with anything, you can try this. When this is done, just going to transfer it onto your plate and then time to eat, time to enjoy great food. This gravy is good. Pour the gravy and look at the gravy also. It is nice. People love this because of the nice gravy. The gravy has a nice flavor because of the chironji and coconut. And see, look at this. I can't even stop pouring this gravy. Let's pour in the chicken curry with this nice gravy. Wow. Because of this coconut, this has got that nice texture also, which, you know, everybody loves. And first, you know, I'm going to try it with this and dip in this curry. Mmm. This one is very wonderful roti. Nice, soft. This is leftover rice from the refrigerator. Mm. And I'm going all crazy about it. And this is usually done in a lot of weddings and other parties in the city. And for me, you know, pouring the entire thing over the rice and then I'm going all hands out. You share this video with your friends via Facebook, WhatsApp, whatever possible. Keep cooking great food because every day I'm posting new recipes for you and I want you to make all these recipes. Once you make these recipes, you will be, you know, what I say is rich. Because richness is, if you are rich in good food, you are the rich person. So enjoy great food and keep saying whatever.